talk about a new scale, a new key, the G major scale. Up to this point, most of our songs, or all of them, were played in C major scale. Now it's time to move forward to a new scale. Because it is called a major scale, it's going to have the same structure as C major scale. Remember our whole steps and half steps. So it's going to be all the same. You start on G, the starting note is G, then you are going to A, and you have whole step in between G and A, then you are going moving to B, and you are having a whole step in between A and B, then B and C are connected with a half step, then C and D are connected with a whole step, D and E are connected with a whole step, E and F sharp are connected with a whole step, and F sharp and G are connected with a half step. Now, if you noticed here, a G major scale has F sharp. So it's not going to be played entirely on the white keys the way we did with C major scale. Because of the structure whole, whole, half, whole, half, that every major scale has to have, we have F sharp. You play F sharp here because you have to follow the structure of a major scale. Whole, whole, half, whole, half. In order to have a whole step between E and F, you have to have F sharp. Because if you do not have F sharp here, you will have E and F white keys, and it's going to be only a half step there. But according to the rule of the major scale, you have to have a whole step. That's why you have this F sharp in the scale itself. Now let's look at our G major scale on the piano. For that, you will need your right hand positioned on G, and you will need to pass and cross your fingers the same way we did with C major scale, because you have only five fingers and you will need to press eight notes. That's why you need to do something with finger numbers here. Now, when you play a scale, you can have F sharp written before F, or if you are playing the actual composition, the F sharp will be positioned by the treble clef or bass clef at the beginning of the composition. So let's start. You start on G, G, A, B, C, D, E, F sharp, G, G, F sharp, E, D, C, B, A, G. If the sharp or flat, F sharp in our case, is at the beginning of the composition by the clef, it will tell us that in the whole composition, or in the four measures or eight measures of a melody or a song, every F note will be sharp. So let's do it again. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 3, 2, 1. So you passed 1 under 3, and then you crossed 3 over 1 here. Let's do the same with our left hand. In the left hand, you see F sharp by the bass clef. It means every F note in this particular scale or four measures of a melody, for example, every F is going to be sharp here. So, and we start on G with finger 1. One, two, three. One, two, three, four, five. Five, four, three, two, one, three, two, one. G, F sharp, E, D, C, B, A, G. G, A, B, C, D, E, F sharp, G. When you feel comfortable with one hand, you can combine both hands, but use the correct finger numbers. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 3, 2, 1. Now you can practice yourself. Now guys, let's look at the son in G major. The whole son will have F sharp and you will be playing in G position. Before we learn the actual son, let's play an exercise here that is based on changing a finger on the same note. So very often when you play piano music, and especially in the advanced piano music, you have to change the finger on the same note. For example, you will be playing on D with 5, 4, 3, 2, 5, 4, 3, 2, or 2, 3, 2, 3, 2, 3, 2, 3, or 3, 2, 4, 3, 2, 4, 3, 2. So there can be different combinations of the finger numbers on the same note. It's done for technical purposes very often in fast music, in very technically advanced music. You will see this very often when you change the finger on the same note. Now, let's play this exercise before the song. So you will start with finger 5 on D. 5, 5. Then you press the same D with finger 4. 4, 4. Then you go to 1, to A or with finger 1, 1, 1, and the same A, 2, 2. So let's do it again. 5, 5, 4, 4, 1, 1, 2, 2. Now let's look at the song itself. You will have to switch the finger on the same note here in a couple of places. Let's look at the son. The whole son is in G major. You have your F sharp sign at the beginning of the son next to the treble clef and bass clef. This sign tells us that every F note in the whole son will be sharp, unless it's cancelled. Remember our cancellation sign. In the whole song, as I can see, there is no natural signs, no cancellation signs. That's why every F note will be sharp. Remember that. The whole song here is in 4-4. It's having very simple rhythm. You will have your whole notes, quarter notes here, and half notes. You have rests in a couple of places, and there should be nothing complicated here. Let's look at one hand at a time. You start with your right hand. I will play with my right hand and count. I start with finger 1 on G. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, So I changed my finger numbers in a couple of measures here. Now let's look at the left hand. I will play my left hand part counting the same way. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now let's play with both hands counting. Remember our F sharp on every F note. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4.